In recent years, a number of videos showing traditional Chinese martial arts pitted against modern combat skills have appeared on the internet. The utility of traditional Chinese martial arts in actual combat was thrown into question. A vigorous debate began among the public, unsettled by this challenge to long-accepted wisdom. What are traditional Chinese martial arts? Who practices them? What is the value of traditional Chinese martial arts in the modern world? China Media Group's documentary channel has undertaken a three-year investigation into China's traditional martial arts. The crew have traveled over 10,000 kilometers around the nation to seek out the origins of traditional Chinese martial arts. As the investigation gradually proceeds, the crew try to lift the mystery veil off these traditional martial arts. The only way to know the true taste of something is to try it. The main body of the crew take intense training in isolation to experience firsthand the actual combat ability of traditional martial arts. The crew have traveled all around China and found many types of martial arts, including some rare types, covering a wide range of varieties. As the investigation and research work progresses further, their perception of martial arts has undergone a subversive transformation. The deeply hidden world of martial arts is gradually revealed. To explore the essence and roots of traditional Chinese martial arts, the crew make a special trip to Jinan University in Guangzhou to visit Professor of History Ma Mingda. The son of Tongbei martial arts master Ma Fengtu, Professor Ma is a senior martial arts culture scholar and a contemporary authority on martial arts theory, literature, and history.
Hey, Ma 半年了啊，我们就终于咱们再见到你。
哦，我这样，我们这个片子我们就算正式要开拍了。那这次我们希望把您所做的中国武术的史学的研究做更清晰的表达，我们也把那些史料东西都希望能够拍到我们的片子里面去。
Professor Ma's study is like a martial arts library. For more than half a century, he has not only inherited and promoted the legacy of his family, but also devoted himself to research on martial arts theory, literature, and history.
这是纪孝信书。
哦，戚继光的。
戚继光纪孝信书呢，我的父亲留给我的一个本子，大名鼎鼎，在武术界人人皆知，因为这是中国古代的军事家所撰写的军事著作中第一次把拳纳入其中。
他有一个拳经解要，
他有一个拳，他第十四卷就是拳经解要篇，这是最重要的军事著作，同时他又是武术著作，因为戚继光前所未有的把很多武术技术的内容收到了这部兵书里，目的就是正本清源。
中国的武术原来是可以有史可查的。
那当然了，那当然。
The Crew's research begins with the actual combat ability of traditional martial arts.
戚继光说，既得意必是敌，这个敌不是指敌人，指对手。那就说戚继光的时代里仍然还是主张武术最重要的区别模式、鉴定模式是竞赛，是竞赛。后来我们渐渐地失去了这样一个竞赛模式，它变成了套路表演。戚继光根本就禁止的，在军队中禁止套子武艺，只图人前好看，上阵无用。所以你们一定分清楚这个概念。现在这个武术不是古代武术。
原来我们中国人真实的武艺、真实的武学，离我们想象中的那个东西简直差得太远了。
是的，是的。
如果我们要做一个严肃的纪录片，我们其实我们也需要重新回过头来，对于史料中我们中国武术、中国武术家、中国武术的史料典籍，要保有足够的尊重，我们才有可能正本清源，有可能让我们的片子回到客观和理性。
中国古代的武艺从源头上讲其实不复杂，因为中国人最早就开始重视两样事情嘛，一个就是所谓戎，戎就是军事活动，要有战争，要有战争能力。第二就是祭，祭祀活动。中华古典武艺一脉相承，一直就是这个样子。戚继光是第一个提出了拳术的价值，是活动手足，贯清肢体，这就是体育价值。练拳大战无用，战场上没有办法吃出空拳和人家搏击，而原本武艺的主体是器械，是兵器。
Traditionally, unarmed fighting is seen as the main body of Chinese martial arts, with weapons portrayed as an extension of those skills. But Professor Ma points out that classical Chinese martial arts originated among the military, where the use of weapons was the priority. The main function of unarmed combat was to strengthen the body and improve coordination and flexibility. Professor Ma recommends the crew explore the pearl of the military martial arts, archery. Shenzhen is one of China's most modern megacities. It's an unexpected place to find a martial arts master proficient in the ancient skill of horseback archery. Instead of a leafy suburb, the crew find themselves in an industrial park, surrounded by factories and workshops. A sign says Shang Wu, or martial spirit, indicates they are in the right place.
Okay.
Li Yun-yi is head of Shenzhen Shangwu International Horseback Archery School. He has been practicing horseback archery for over a decade. Before founding his school, he was a top neurosurgeon from a medical family.
2014年的时候，我代表中国去参加匈牙利的世界骑射比赛。我们的成绩是特别特别糟糕。我们这个民族在骑射方面过去是很辉煌的，但是那一场比赛几十个国家，我们基本上是垫底的。当时对我的刺激真的是非常非常的大。就那个时候，我就知道我应该要离开我这个医疗的行业，觉得好像这个就是我本身该要做的事情。让中华骑射强大起来，走向世界的巅峰，这是我的初心。
中华民族是世界上射箭最早的民族之一，弓、弩，这是中国古代武艺中最重要的、最高端，是人人必练必会的。它自身的技术含量和科技含量都是第一位的，所以射始终在中国古典武艺里居于榜首。
Archery, which tops the list of classical Chinese martial arts, was included among the six arts of the gentleman in the early first millennium BCE.In the military imperial examinations of the Tang Dynasty, over 1,000 years later, archery, blade fighting, stone lifting, equestrianism, agility, and horseback archery were all compulsory skills. This selection system for military officials continued until the Qing Dynasty, when it included drawing a hard bow, horseback archery, and archery. Horseback archery has always been a core skill in classical martial arts.In Li Yun-yi's private collection, one can see the previous glory of this almost forgotten ancient martial art.
现在看的这把弓呢，我们叫硬弓啊，也叫立弓。这个是清早期时期的一把硬弓，是用于武科举科考，其中有一个科考项目叫做开硬弓，也就我手上拿的这种硬弓，它磅数特别高，达到了。180磅以上，
你觉得现在的人操控它怎么样？
特别特别困难，
很困难，
特别困难。在以前的武科举科考的时候，开弓的时候也就是这样。上开弓之后停留多长时间，就是为一个合格者。当然了，这把弓的磅数并没有刚才那把弓的磅数那么高，因为弓呢，基本上是用于战场。就是用来杀敌的，所以呢，他对力量这方面的把控的话，他的考核会要求也是挺高的。
It requires not only strength, but also speed and accuracy.
其实它属于古典武，它是具备相当大的杀伤性的，乃立国之本。在武举科考当中是特别特别特别重视的。
The development of advanced firearms saw the bow exit from the stage of history. But if no longer a military art, archery remained strong in the field of folk arts.
射箭从来都是中华古代武艺的核心，长期居于中华武艺的顶端位置。所以他对其他的武艺形式都有非常广泛深刻的印象嘛。我们现在练的武术的很多东西都是从射箭引出来的嘛。那么骑印的训练它有一套办法，比如站桩，你不能马上就骑马，你必须先站桩练习你掌控马镫的能力，这是一个非常严格的练习过程嘛。很多练武术的人在那练桩，骑马蹲桩式、骑马站桩式，它都是从骑射来的。
女孩别挂。
These days, Li Yun-yi is dedicated to training young enthusiasts in horseback archery. He has selected 6 outstanding students for intensive training, hoping that they can represent China in the World Horseback Archery Championship and win. Archery was used in the ancient battlefield to kill from a distance. When ancient armies closed with each other, the spear was the main weapon to take the fight to the enemy. As one of the compulsory subjects in classical martial arts, the spear is also known as the king of weapons. The crew go to Shujia Chuang to look for an ancient spear skill. They discover it is related to a secret unarmed fighting skill, which Xue Li Shen, a railway police captain, uses in his daily work. Xue Li Shen's master is Xu Jianyi, an inheritor of Mianjiang Chuan. Early the next morning, the crew meet Master Xu in the park where he usually teaches martial arts. On meeting him, the crew learn that Xu Jianyi suffered a sudden stroke 10 years ago. It has left him unable to move one side of his body, and his speech has been affected too. Are the skills they're practicing the same as those used in the ancient battlefield? The experts have confirmed that although these spear skills have retained a large number of military aspects, they have already turned into folk skills. Professor Zhou Wei-liang, a famous martial arts culture scholar, has clear views on the transformation of these martial arts applications into folk skills.
很早之时，民间就开始有习武风气。冷兵器战场上的军礼武艺，肯定是武术的文化源头。军礼武艺往往是阵战，而武术仅仅是两两相当的个体性私斗，就是先秦，确切的说在春秋，已经慢慢开始形成了自己的文化分化。武艺和武术是有差别的。
How were spears used on the ancient battlefield? The spear skills recorded in ancient military texts are simple and direct. Their goal is to kill as quickly as possible.
Jun 里武术九斤讲果，我不管你什么圣人，我十个人打你一个打死你也是果。武术不能这样，武术不光是一对一，以弱胜强，以柔克刚，以静制动，后发先至。他不仅仅是强调圣人，他更追求如何圣人。他自认为这才是武术的积极要义所在。
因为我们老觉得是这样，我们现在看着这么长，他可能舒服点。
有长枪短用，长枪短用，
长枪短用啊。但是我看到刚才他做的那个动作，我估计我就可能我连举都举不起来。哎，
不要。
After martial arts were adopted into folk traditions, more attention was paid to the training of skills and the application of skills. Differences in purposes and practice groups saw the forms change, but the goal of beating your opponent has always been the same.
武术尽管在冷兵器时期，它和军事武艺中开始分化出来，但是它始终和军礼武艺保持着若即若离的关系，他们是盘根错节的，你中有我，我中有你。
手头就是枪，这个劲儿从腿上起，作用在身上，出在手头上，这就是打枪作用。第二拳，好，第二拳，好。
这个打枪在动起来之后，它是一个纺锤状或者是一个枣核状，中间的部位在高速的非常有力的在旋转在运动，什么兵器来了一下就给崩飞了。
Shu Jianyi is obviously not satisfied with his student's spear skills. Regrettably, he is no longer able to swing this long spear now. One can get a glimpse of Shu's style spear from footage filmed in 2006.
武术从本质上说，它应该是为了提高技击能力而进行的一种身体活动。就说我练少林的也好，我练太极也好，我练形意也好，我都是为了提高技击能力进行的一种训练方法，这是它的内在规定性。它的外延就是它适用的范围，第一它以套路，第二是格斗。除了套路以外，他为了提高技击能，他必须要进行格斗训练方法。第三个就是功法。那么这个功法，他是为了增强自己的技击能力，一定是技击能力而进行的一种特殊的训练手段。
After martial arts moved from the military sphere to the civilian, the skills became more and more sophisticated, and the forms became more complex.Many of the weapon skills evolved into training methods for use in unarmed combat, and the word chuan, or fist, was gradually applied to many of the martial arts styles.
啊，里边打拳的时候有很多枪的枪法、步法，它本身就是一种搏击的技能。啊，这个是非常珍贵的、优秀的，这个先人给我们留下的智慧的结晶。绵掌拳。如果作为一门武艺的话，跟当前现代社会流传的武术还有很大的区别。绵掌拳的技艺是来自于古典的军旅，那么真正它的存在价值应该还是在军旅。
Now, Mianzhang Chuan, a type of classical martial arts that originated from military, is re-emerging in the public eye.
它明明打上在这位置上。
Shu Jianyi recommends a visit to the International Security Defense College in a Beijing suburb to discover more.
来，请，这边请。
Hidden behind a high protective wall lies a counter-terrorism security training base.
第三个呢，我们是培训海外的使领馆、中支机构这些安保人员。一号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到位！二号到
民章拳非常吸引我的呢，是近距离格斗过程当中，身体的每一个点都可以成为攻击或防守的武器。
压的同时，给对方的下面的身体进行一个控制。那么第二个呢，对方手持匕首反握向我们进攻，跟我们所学习的是接近的，而且也是用惊爆力量快速的把对方的匕首打开，同时对对方的身体圈臂。控制住对方手里的武器，这也是我们这个绵掌拳当中的很重要的一个惊暴力的弹抖力量。就像我们之前练习的对方出拳，我们用非常重要非常重要的基本功胆手的进攻，防跟打是同时的，所以这一点呢是我们大家全部都要有效掌握的。
要想达到实战应用，唯一一个要求就是没有任何规则的状态下展开疯狂的砍杀或者刺杀或者打击训练。这些我们所展示的都是来自于传统武术的相关技法。绵掌拳的棍法实战应用性非常强，我把它演练变成我们的防爆技术。
花式跳过来，花式看，这跳过来，或者花式顶出去，打，就是花式看这个，打过来以后再这样上看。这样是花式，你走打去走，要是打花式打过来杀手。
因为我们教授的目标绝大多数是军警人员，刹那间有可能生死相隔的问题，所以我们教授的武艺还是以搏杀为主。
注意看，对方手枪拿起来，
别动啊！
我要快速的满足，哎，兄弟，放松放松，
都弄死你啊！
我心里有钱，千万别杀我。在这过程当中，一定是躲开枪口的。当他枪击发也打不到我，并且我要把枪口朝向他自己。如果他开枪击伤是他自己，一定要躲开枪口的前提，躲开枪口的前提才有可能把枪变成你的枪。不然的话，我们看这个枪已经上膛。如果你的身体没有躲开，你对对方展开动作，你有可能被对方击毙。
所以大家一定要清楚的认知，每天训练时间6到10个小时，从饮食结构到训练内容到其他的后勤保障，完全是规范合理的科学的一种模式。我们传统民间武术来讲，没有任何一个门派能做到一天练6到9个小时到10个小时，而且每天都有实战接触，所以呢结果将会完全不同。所以并不是说我们传统武术包括我们传统技法不行，而是训练方式不同，所以它表现出来的结果就不同。
On the ancient battlefield, the spear was the typical long weapon. The most common short-range weapon was the blade. These days, blade skills are a common sight in martial arts performances and are a compulsory part of the course for martial arts majors at colleges, universities, and folk martial arts schools. But these modern blade skills are no longer of use in real combat. Instead, they focus on difficulty, creativity, and ornamental value.But not everyone is sticking to this new path. This is an attempt to rediscover a set of the ancient practical blade skills that can be passed on.
我们今天练的所有称之为苗刀的这套技术方法，就是源自明代的陈同斗的单刀法拳。然后它是经过战争、经过格杀、经过生命、经过流血来验证的技术。器名单刀，以双手用一刀也。其技自倭奴，就是来自倭寇。
来自倭寇。
Professor Ma Mingda has studied the two-handed blade skills practiced in China, Japan, and North Korea. He has drawn the conclusion that these skills were adopted by the Japanese from China. In Japan, they were developed and improved by the samurai before returning.Unwelcomely to China with the Japanese pirates in the Ming Dynasty. In order to recover these classical skills, Zhang Jianjun is allowed to select a number of the top students at the school for meticulous training.
他们为什么会是您认为比较合适的人选？第一，他们是这个学院的青年骨干教师和一些研究生。第二，这个年轻人身体素质在这里，研究生和高校的教师，他对武艺、武术，包括体育运动，他这个理解能力够了，所以他们是最适合来做一个传承和继承的，让真正的武艺回归，让这个苗刀恢复到当年的军队里面高手的那种水平，只有他们才能做到，甚至超越当年的那种状态。
他要抽枪，我上肘我就降了，听见没有？你下枪架枪了，一下子再次出来，就是我架起，人家又回来了，我只能这样，看到没有？哎，只能用我这样走，哎，靠进去一脚，用刀在捅他。倭刀进入中国以后，刘玉春加入了一个非常非常中国人的概念，就是把苗刀 当枪使了，这个变化应该是在原有的基础上往前跨了一大步。我们从技术层面讲，就是变化更多、更细腻一些。
一二三四五，跑过去，是，对。OK，好，来，没有你动我前往前，刷到这里，还可以快走这个，就是。
Although these young people are used to showing off their skills with a training blade, they look daunted when they pick up the steel training weapons, even with their blunted blades.
Look, 你走，你走是这样的搞，能搞到人吗？你要走，你只有这样，你刀这个位置走吗？你下去我就在这。第二，看着啊，还有的还这样。哎，哎，搞一个这个，这就是跳舞，这搞不得啊。身体蹲下来，为什么蹲下来？
重心，发力。古人有强调的。 近代人有强调，现代人有强调的武术的技击和健身，它是一体的。我为了提高技击呢，必须要强壮身体。你没有健康的身体，怎么去练习技击呀？反之，练好身体以后，我是为了技击。它是一元论，但是这种一元论的观点到近代以后，慢慢被割裂了，所以武术就成了操武化的东西。武术走向单一模式发展，叫做竞技武术，以表演来代替比赛。 就是把各式各样的套路表演用体操评分的模式去掉一个最高分，去掉一个最低分，然后把它称之为比赛，它就本质是舞蹈，它是模仿武术的一种舞蹈化表演。我们的武术之所以出现这么尴尬的局面，就是因为我们的武术明显地走了一条舞蹈化的道路。
长期以来，他就缺乏这种赛事制度的东西，他就无法推进这种技术上的不断的向前推进。因此，他的武术今天我们一看武术一打一，好像不会打一样，那是就成了必然了。来，一枪、两枪，对了，他这样他才有用吗？到一定的基础以后，要两人对抗，你不能自己在这里闭着眼睛练，那个就麻烦了。对，我们在格杀中间是不是思维的博弈？ 这个时候你必须学会放弃什么。第二，不管你赢了和输了，你要面对这个结果。第三，当我们在竞技场上格杀的时候，没有人帮你，只有你自己帮你。你马上可以感受到什么叫勇者无惧，不是黑瓶酒提拔刀去砍人。As
cold weapons are largely a thing of the past, most have simply become props for performance. Zhang Jianjun still hasn't found his own proper blade. It's a common problem for martial artists now. To try to solve this problem, the crew travel with Zhang to Longchun, a city famed for its sword and blade making in Zhejiang province.
这种作业不好做，您之前来过？我没来过龙泉，这是第一次。期不期待？就是肯定期待，这个想都不用想。我现在都不知道真正他用手工打制的刀到底拿在手里是什么感觉。如果我用去他去砍削或者是什么劈一个物那个实物的时候，什么感觉？这个肯定是期待的，因为你练的这个技术，你就是用这个东西来才能展现出来嘛。
Hu Xiaojun has been making swords and blades using the ancient techniques for many years. He is keen to have Zhang Jianjun try the Miao Dao he has made in recent years.
这有一段是不开刃的，有一段是不开刃的，上面有油，我们可以把这个擦一下。不用，不要擦，保护它好一点。我给你擦，我这个，有一点点，我自己觉得，发力发的点的时候，它容易偏差，偏差我感觉可能是跟这个有点关系。厚薄有点点关系，我们再拿一个试一下，
可以再，
你看好吧？
感觉一下别人。
This is the first time that Zhang Jianjun has the chance to wield a blade made according to ancient
techniques.
这个好一些，感觉手感也好一点。这把是将近600年的老刀，您可以看一下。600年，对，您看一下，沧桑啊，这上面是。 都已经就是有锈迹斑斑，真的是锈，感觉就是说，它就是我想心目中的那个配重，比这个更接近。嗯，这个刀是多重？
这把刀有3斤重，这个呢，2斤6，2斤6，相差4两，但是这个感觉这个比它还要轻。
对，因为什么呢？因为它的重心又往后靠了，
它这个整个是铁的，这个是配重
铜的，这都是铜的，
哦，铜的配重。
Holding the 600-year-old blade, Zhang Jianjun feels he has found the weapon of his dreams.
来，刺穿，就是连续往上都走。这个，哎呦，走。
Though Hu Xiaojun has been making blades for many years, this is the first time that he has seen the ancient fighting skills demonstrated. Hu is confident he can make the Miao Dao Zhang Jianjun wants so badly. It is as if China's warriors and craftsmen from ancient times are reunited across the centuries. The transformation of crude iron into keen steel blade takes lengthy forging and tempering. And the ancient warriors were themselves tested and tempered in the blood and fire of battle. Today, the skills of warriors and techniques of swordsmiths have been confined to history. But there remain some martial artists and craftsmen dedicated to the recovery of the spirit of the ancients. Three months later, Zhang Jianjun's long-awaited blade finally appears before him.
Why do we still have to focus on the strength of the ancients?
Leaving Zhang Jianjun, the crew returned to Beijing to film an upcoming mixed martial arts fight. An expert's tip received during the crew's pre-production interview brings about this change of schedule.
中国教可观赏性强，可比性强，可观，精彩，充满中国智慧。因为一直以来他们都认为这种摔跤不是中国武术，
什么不是中国武术？看看中国武术史，看看从头到尾，一开始我跟你简单说，皇帝师幼，师幼的部落战争时候啊，
这是你的，
就是这个，在演变中首搏还是摔，啊，宋代打擂台主要还是摔，让中国教回归武术，
这是我回来的。
走。
摔跤它其目的就是把对方摔倒，在部队里砸仗、交手仗，尤其是交手仗，在冷兵的时代呢是管事儿的。它又叫君子之争。完了，
不然你上战场了，你看。
Wrestling is not only a popular way for folks to compete in martial arts. In the long era of cold weapons.It was always a way to improve soldiers' morale and close combat skills. Yao Honggang, in the red, started practicing Chinese wrestling in 2006. He's been at it for over a decade. In a few days, he will take his Chinese wrestling skills to the MMA ring.He aims to show that this ancient skill still has practical value today. From the beginning, Yao has been undertaking intense fight training almost every day. Very few folk martial artists could manage that.
Swordplay 本身是我的强项，我再练稍微练练拳就可以了。你要是我直接比如去转自由搏击，就需要好长时间。人家都练六年了，我再快我也得三年，因为我有摔跤的底子，有几年。综合格斗我可能一年我就能跟六年的打。
这种到了顶尖的这种竞赛的人群，他才能推动这个技艺的不断的向前发展，就需要不同的另外一种人群来进行这方面的技艺训练、专业化训练。反之，只能是自娱自乐。它本身就是一个分层结构。
This is set to be a fierce fight. Yao Honggang is about to fight against an old rival of his, Zhu Ma Bieku, Tu Ar Shun. Zhu Ma Bieku is a strong, well-rounded fighter and also a good wrestler.
This 个对手嘛，经验上也是比较丰富，在国内几乎没输过。
MMA is a combat sport.With extremely open rules. In the ring, the fighters can use all their skills, including stand-up striking skills and ground fighting skills, to subdue their opponents. MMA is recognized as the most wide-ranging combat sport. Yao Honggang sees Chinese wrestling as the key to victory in the ring. After a tough fight, Yao won with a slim point advantage. The generally ignored Chinese wrestling has shown its value and importance as part of Chinese martial arts. The Chinese character Wu, for martial, took its form from two elements, representing stop and spear. Instead of withdrawing the weapon, Wu originally shows the image of a warrior who stands firmly on his battlefield. Throughout history, Chinese martial arts have transformed from the battlefield to the popular folk arena. Although their function and form have changed, the core of real martial arts has always been actual combat skills.
表演可以有，但你就是表演。大众练武术是为了健身，也不比人人都去比试。但武术的高端，表达你武术真正实力的，一定是比试，有规则的比试，这样恢复我们中华民族古代武术的立体结构。而这个立体结构的核心是势，是戚继光讲的既得意必是敌。要有身术，我的父亲经常讲那一句话：无分内家外家，只有赢家输家。